I am Noël Conruit, and I work as a researcher in computer science at the University of Réunion Island. And in fact, I am also a biologist and a guitarist. So I want to apply computer science to the management of biodiversity and music. This presentation is about eco-innovation for making e-services. And I will use the concept of Living Labs, which is a human-centered digital ecosystem for education with ICT. I will explain the concept of Living Lab and, through an example in instrumental music learning, introduce the methodological approach that we have investigated, which is called Sign Management, and a tool, the Creativity Platform, for enhancing teaching and learning by playing at University of Réunion Island. On this slide, I show you where is Réunion Island on the planet. It is a small tropical island in the southwest of Indian Ocean, between Mauritius and Madagascar. It is a French overseas department. Réunion Island is like a little planet in the middle of the ocean, with a population growing towards 1 million of inhabitants on a small surface of 2,500 square kilometers. In purple, you can see the Réunion National Park covering 40% of this area. Thus, Réunion Island can be viewed as a little laboratory of the world for managing resources with people. On the natural diversity, the biodiversity heritage of Réunion is rated as one of the official hotspots in red. And on cultural diversity, there are also singing and dancing heritages called Sega and Maloya. And the second one was inscripted on the urgent safeguarding list of UNESCO. In the paper, I introduced eco-innovation as a new form of electronic and collaborative innovation that respects the ecology, the ecosystems, the education, and the ethics, and which has for state the knowledge, economy, and society. It makes use of the co-working business approach and the co-learning usage approach with people in order to co-design new products and services. And Living Labs are a way to go in the sustainable direction. Here are three definitions of what is a Living Lab. It is a real-life test and experimentation environment where users and producers co-create tools, services, and new uses. Living Labs are also well suited to new ICT innovation ecosystems that are open, smart, and inclusive in the Knowledge Society of the European Horizon 2020. And lastly, Living Labs have been characterized by the UC as 4P, public, private, people, partnerships, where public and private actors, enterprise, associations, individuals, practice user-driven open innovation. In the last definition, what are the problems dealt with these 4Ps? The problems are how to know to get the future user needs and behaviors, how to come with innovative products and services, how to take advantage of future internet, and how to come up with the right business model, and how to export know-how to do business outside of the territory. I will propose a response to the first question. Knowing needs and behaviors. The Living Labs come from MIT with the ideas of democratizing innovation and experiment products and services with end users in real-life environments. For Eric Von Hippel, lead users are the real innovators more than enterprises. They do it essentially for themselves and by pleasure. So we must identify them and follow their needs. On the other side, William Mitchell made the proof of concept arise in the domain of domotics with PlaceLab, which incorporates hundreds of sensors and in a home in order to observe and analyze lead users' behaviors when they test solutions. So what we do in a living lab? In Living Labs, the user-centric research methodology is adopted to get to know the future needs and behaviors of end users. It applies four principles, activities, which the first one is co-creation, for co-designing products and e-service by motivated end users and producers. Second one is exploration, by discovering emerging usages, behaviors, and market opportunities. Then there is experimentation by implementing the live scenarios with communities of practice. And lastly, evaluation with the assessment of concepts, products, and e-services according to sociologic, ergonomic, economic, and cognitive criteria. The Enol network is resumed by this map. Since the start of the European network of Living Labs in 2006, Living Labs were created and are supported by the European Commission in their digital agenda. And we got our certification at the University of La Réunion in 2011. Here are some more links about Living Labs in Europe. In France also there is an association, there is a didactic presentation in Quebec, and at Réunion Island I put some information in my website. In Réunion Island we have co-designed a living lab. In fact, we would like to co-design Réunion Island as a living lab of the world. More precisely, we want to educate people to the richness of their natural and cultural heritage that needs to be preserved. Here is the natural heritage of Réunion Island. It is a little world that is facing big challenges in terms of managing biodiversity with the growth of population and tourism. The question is how to preserve the natural environment from human degradations. We make the hypothesis that each individual can preserve the richness of common good, for example, the marine and terrestrial heritage, only by better knowing it and loving it. And for knowing something, the first step of the process is to recognize the living organisms that live on the territory. By analogy, when we say hello to somebody, we are able to identify him with his name and his surname, and then take care of him. It's an education principle for living in good harmony in society and also in nature. So the skill to acquire is to know how to observe in order to identify correctly living beings. For cultural heritage now, the education problem is the same. When dealing with the cultural heritage, one can preserve the richness of a culture only by better knowing it. It's done by observing, manipulating, practicing, playing the activity. And of course, understanding it with the help of professors. Here are three examples of this cultural heritage in Réunion Island. Music on the left, dance in the middle, and cooking on the right. They share the same gesture management problem for mastering an art. How to learn the good hand movement in order to get a nice sound in music, or how to catch the correct gesture for dancing well, and what are the tricks to get the nice taste for fine cooking of a dish. For our research in the domain of arts, we focused ourselves on knowing how to play well guitar or piano pieces. So, in our laboratory of informatics and mathematics, we want to investigate the thematic of teaching and learning by playing, for co-designing better education services with ICT. So what did we do already? For teaching knowledge, our first field of activity was to enhance environmental sciences by better knowing the richness of Réunion National Park with its volcano and circus. So the Insular Tropical Environment and ICT program called ETIC allowed us to transmit knowledge, which is one-way teaching from specialists with a knowledge-based management system called Iterative Knowledge-Based System, IKBS. It was used to model, describe, classify, identify specimens for biodiversity management. The result is a knowledge base that can be linked to information databases when we know the name of the specimen. Then, in the following ETIC program called NextIC, we worked on the interoperability between this data and knowledge base modules. So here is the teaching of knowledge, which is one way from professor to learners. The other way is to learning know-how. And we focused ourselves on interpretations rather than knowledge. Know-how is the living knowledge, not to teach, but to learn, because it can only be shown with multimedia. Know-hows are interpretations of specialists that are vital for knowledge acquisition and understanding by students for learning. For example, the activity of correctly observe and describe a specimen of coral reefs or tropical forest is a challenging process for getting a right identification. The activity also of making the right gesture for playing a piece of music is central for getting the beautiful sound and shared emotions. These are practical knowledge to learn, and we investigated them in the eGuitar project. For this know-how in sciences and arts, we will speak about right interpretations of objects, which are biological specimens or musical pieces, by subjects who are experts or amateurs. Lastly, the playing highlights the need to play seriously in order to learn properly. So we co-developed serious games, like the eCampus project on the left and the eFish project on the right, with voluntary and private partners to understand the use of virtual learning in the younger generation accustomed to video games. These learning games invite people to interact with information differently by being immersed in the virtual environment that is also the real geographical one. This immersive web can be reproduced on tablets and brought in the fields, then connected to real objects by using the Internet of Things. It is the next big challenge to access to information in the virtual and real space dimension. And all these projects form the content of our living lab that is at the convergence of bio and cultural diversity and ICT. So our vision is territorial and social innovation. As we say, we want to co-design Réunion Island as a living lab of the world. We consider that the co-creation of e-services with students and professors in Réunion Island University is a territorial and social innovation. Our living lab in teaching and learning by playing uses the concept of co-design for learning to innovate with people on the territory. And in our research team, the shift of paradigm that we want to investigate is to pass from knowledge transmission, which is one way of teaching, to what we are called science sharing, which is bidirectional teaching and learning by playing. When applying ICT to this interpretation sharing strategy, all the above keywords, serious games, game-based learning, all what is in orange, must be considered seriously for co-designing e-services. After explaining our vision, here are the objectives of our Living Lab. Our objective is then to teach and learn by playing. The sharing of expertise is our aim in education for some specific domains such as managing biodiversity, performing an art, music, dance, speaking a language, welcoming tourists also, or cooking. These niches can be enhanced with ICT in a sustainable manner by following some innovative methods for managing subject interpretations. What we call, in fact, sign management of the semiotic web. And the final objective is to make e-services to share know-how with people. How to reach such objectives? We have some means in our Living Labs. We propose to produce sign bases by managing know-how rather than knowledge bases. And these new applications are made of interpretations of objects by subjects for knowing how to do things with multimedia content. This is a step further than knowing what are these things in formal and textual knowledge bases. So we linked words with videos. And we must organize new decision help tools called iterative sign-based systems. By combining classification and signification processes in an iterative and constructivist process. The resulting e-services are co-designed on a creativity platform. Here is a creativity platform. On our Living Lab method, we make both usage and business objects converge for co-designing e-services on this platform. And the methods start from an idea at the center here, then verbalize a concept, concretize a mock-up, evaluate it, then build iteratively different prototypes that are significant for real use. Lead users who are practitioners are indeed the co-designers of these e-services. I will give an example now in music playing. In fact, the creativity platform is at the center of the spiral, and we experimented for several years different kinds of applications and tools, for example, DVDs, online platforms, and tablets, in order that they best fit user needs for bringing the professor at home to learn music pieces. The creativity platform must not be confused with the multimedia platform because it is a physical meeting space for researchers, developers, entrepreneurs, and users for co-working and co-learning the characteristics of e-services that are best suited to target desires and real use of end users. So here we have got business object on the left here. Yeah. The production platform, and here the usage objects, which is the experimentation platform. I will not explain the methodology further, but in fact we must conciliate the production process on the left and the usage process on the right. Now, my concern is to pass from knowledge management to something called sign management. In fact, knowledge management is necessary but not sufficient for learning to cook or to play pieces of music. Knowledge resides in the head of individuals or in books, such as here for cooking on the left, and score on the right. But we can manage know-how, that is information exchanged between the teacher and the learner. The most important task is to practice the domain of interest with some teacher advice. And there is still a difference between knowing the recipe of a dish and cooking it with its ingredients, or reading a score of music and playing it with the guitar or the piano, or having keys for identifying species in the fields and observe characters of specimens for getting the right name. Our role as computer scientists is to enhance the best practices of teachers who are experts in order to motivate learners to play these activities. Now I will speak about sign management, which deals with different interpretations. And in our living lab, we introduce this notion for dealing with know-how on top of knowledge, because we want to stress the importance of the qualitative interpretations of music pieces made by teachers. These interpretations can only be shown with multimedia contents. This is why we want to co-design tools that show the gesture of a professor by producing the right sound on an offline support as DVDs or on the web. For playing classical guitar pieces, we need the professor with the subject, and our idea was to conceive a tool to get some advice of professor at home for playing a piece of guitar. For example, with the score of Forbidden Games, the teacher is then our expert, and we have to communicate with him for co-designing the product and the service. I don't know if you heard about what is called Forbidden Games. I just have. So the professor is our first concern. After you get the formal notation of the music piece in scores that are put into form in brochures and digitalized, it is the syntactical information of the music piece. But how to convert into this score into practical knowledge? You need explanations of the professors. And you can find on YouTube a lot of interpretations that have been captured. You can easily decide which one you prefer. And this is a starting point for anybody wanting to play an instrument. We want to reproduce emotions that we experience when hearing a lovely interpretation. For myself, it was the interpretation of Forbidden Games by Narciso Yepes that inspired me to play classical guitar. And this content part is of the sign is made of multimedia objects. So the sign is the central notion made of subject, data, information, and lastly, knowledge. The best way to learn guitar pieces is to access to fingering advice from music teachers who have the qualitative knowledge to explain the technical gesture for producing the correct interpretations. So we can design different kinds of tools that respond to different needs. On the left, the e-guitar DVD for teaching music pieces. Then on the right, but you don't see something here, it is an online approach. It is an e-learning approach called Flash Interactive Guitar Salon for learning technical advice of professors with webcams. And lastly, we design a mobile system that augments, in fact, written notations, scores with multimedia contents called annotations. And the system is called AMUSE. Because the problem for learning classical music is to have a professor, then you must have scores, and after you have to learn how to capture the right gesture that produces a nice sound. And the scores are fingerings, because professors show them now how in live courses, but can only write their comments with a lead pencil on scores, and this is not sufficient. If we could have videos, it would be better. What is a musical sign? It is the interpretation of an object by a subject at a given time and place, which takes into account its content, data, fact, event, its form, the information, and its sense or meaning, which is called knowledge. There are as many interpretations as subjects, and some are better than others. If I want to take an example, instrumental teaching and learning, with the Forbidden Games piece of the guitar, the challenge is to play well this piece of music with the help of new e-services, and how can sign management help for this activity? Learning by playing is often based on gesture reproduction by imitating the professor. So it is important for pedagogy to show how to do the right movement in order to be able to decompose it into instructions and understand the produced result in consequence. The process of a course is the following. You have the teachers that suggest a new piece, you present it to the learner, and now after the student learns progressively at home, the teacher corrects mistakes, gives advices, and when technical aspects are solved, the learner can focus on interpretation and play the piece in music, and you go on with another piece. Our idea was to imagine to have the pieces on the DVD, watching the hands of the teacher on the television, making close-ups, slow motion, backups, replays, and everything is possible while you can learn to play along with the teacher in order to assist you, check music lights to each note as it is being played. All this is in full screen, high definition video, and natural stereo sound. In addition, the teacher's advice are associated with the notes and the measures in play in the form of visual and verbal commentary. When we experimented the project with end users, we improved the interface effectively from mock-up to prototypes and to final product service. For example, here on the television, the first DVD was conceived for learning on the television, but in fact it is not possible to learn in a salon where the television is. So we had to design an application on DVD for going in the bedroom where we can better learn. The interactive DVD has this interface, can be shown on the web. For example, here we have buttons for switching from one camera to another, to slow down, to get piece of advice, and this view is composite in order to observe both ends simultaneously. And there is a karaoke on score notes and finger positions on the tablature. But end users wanted to ask questions to the professor. So we had to design another product on the web for sharing live interpretations, what we called a closed system. Here is a capture of the interface, which was called Close to You. On the left is a professor, and under him we see the variable glosses for the music piece. When we click on one of them, we switch on the right to the video of the user who posted a gloss. And in this dialogue, I posted two questions about left and right fingering on a portion of the piece that can be seen between the markers of the teacher's video. And we can see that the professor answered to me because there is one reply to my gloss. After this solution, we tried to mix both DVD and internet solution. The education process must also become bidirectional between teachers and learners to be more attractive and efficient. It is why a famous guitarist called Andrés Segovia said that in his career, students were his best teachers. Lastly, Amuse was a tablet application that we designed for annotating digital scores with multimedia contents. And the score is embedded in music XML format. This project is called ePiano. The musical signs are made of emotional content, technical symbols and tacit knowledge, and associated with culture know-how. These elements can be manipulated through score annotation, which is a common practice in piano learning. I will jump just to the prototype and finish on this presentation. Here is a demo of the Amuse project. So you can load a piece of a score of music. Then you get the annotations of the professors. You can work with the annotation to reproduce the same gesture. So with your webcam you can add an annotation that you put in the score. So what is interesting here is that you can connect words with videos to explain or to show the interpretation. After that, you can also annotate with written inscriptions. And give an explanation by loading an annotation, video annotation. Like add video. You record your interpretation. Okay, I will stop there. So this prototype was co-designed with professors. Here it was for the piano, but it interests guitarists also. On the environmental aspect, I will not speak about what we did, because that time. In fact, my My conclusion is to introduce semiotic web rather than semantic web. In fact, it is a web of science rather than the web of things. In the context of future internet, we must put the subject rather than the object at the center of the educational process. And enhance semiotic web, which is the semantics of humans, rather than semantic web, which is the semantics of machines. It is the context of the future internet with ultra high speed broadband networks, so we can show with videos how to practice know-how. The technology must be at the service of human content, not the contrary. Since the Web 2.0, personalization and usage are the rules for making its services. Individuals innovate for themselves, and in this new era, it is urgent that qualitative experiences be acknowledged in both scientific and artistic domains, because we must build a sustainable life by educating citizens to the richness of their natural and cultural heritage. I thank you very much for your attention.
Yeah, only a small audience here, but it's called a muse, your prototype, it's accessible through the web.
It is a tablet, it is accessible on the tablet.
On the tablet?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it is connected to the web.
Yes.
The platform.
So could we also use it in Germany also? Is it available?
You know, this work has been done by my PhD student, who had the best paper award by Google.
Yes.
And she was in contact with MuseCore, which is the open office of the music.
Right.
It is an open source software.
Yes.
Widely used.
Widely used.
And there are more than 30,000 scores on the web.
Yeah.
And the idea is to work with them to develop further this prototype. Because
right.
It's a prototype. It's made by a PhD student.
Yeah. I like to get people, at least first one or two triggers from the music field to contact you and then to contact her, that she walks them through it and that they get it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's great.
Yes.
Tied a little bit of shortage. At Stanford, there's an e-school, design school. They are on creativity in education. This fits in also very, very well for a certain part that they are doing.
Mm.
And they're doing different things. But to have like the science and the emotion, the motivation, that would be used for many things, for seed, for example. In your homeland, how many kids are using it, for example?
In fact, it is a process of innovation.
Yes.
We started with a DVD, and we made 500 exemplaries of this DVD, and we tested it.
Right.
Music schools, and in fact, it was the people were very, very keen of the approach.
Yes.
We could not make. More, it was in Reunion Island, so we were in the closed world. In fact, when we presented this prototype, some people from MIT took the idea and developed it in America.
So
now it's commercialized on the DVD, on tablets. It's our interface on the tablet is commercialized in the
right.
US.
Yeah.
But we jumped to another process because the learners wanted to talk with the professors. So we did an internet application which called the Glossy system for giving questions and answers between the professor with the webcams.
Yes.
And after that, we had to inscript videos in the timeline. And after after that, we found the idea it was better to inscript this video in the score, in the part of the score, one note or measure, anything else. And that's it. We are at this moment now with this prototype, but it's not used in a music school, for example.
Yeah.
We need tablets.
Yes.
But we have not got the money to buy
this tablet. You're an ex-PhD student. What is she doing now? Is she working somewhere or?
She will she will speak about this PhD in October. She will make a defense.
Okay, yes, okay, like that. Yes.
In October. That's it.
Wonderful.
Thank you very much.
And I also have to present my things. I will make it very short. I do it in a couple of minutes. Here, the one about when I'm in this track, no?
Mm-hmm.
Are you the track chair now? Or?
No.
Who's the track chair?
Okay. There is no track chair.
So I